One of the persistent criticisms of the Eden Project over the years has been its massive carbon footprint. 86% of visitors arrive by car.
Eden and transport, Eden and traffic. Well, when Eden opened, the site was built for about 650,000 people, and in our first year we had 1.8 million visitors, which was absolutely great, but it meant that we had very bad traffic problems in the first year. There were 75 days of serious queuing on the highway. In 2003, we started our travel plan. We have targets for 30% of all visits to the site to be done by means other than a single person in a private car. So we try really, really hard to get people here by means other than the car. And for years and years, our attainment of the target has not been possible. And it's not only not been possible, it's getting worse.
The Eden Project may not be able to change society, but it can play a part in changing how we think. That's the idea behind their exhibition, the Sexy Green Car Show. They want to demonstrate that a car with good environmental performance can still be desirable.
Basically, if we all move to the most efficient car in every class, emissions from car transport would go down by 30%. But until public policy changes and rural integrated transport is a reality, we're never going to get more people out of them, we don't think.
Once they've got here, one of the biggest environmental impacts visitors will have is the food they eat and the waste they generate. How are the Eden Project managing mass catering while sticking to sustainable practices?
We support the Cornish economy, that we support local businesses, and also when they come through here, we actually make sure that they're looking at their packaging, that they're looking at their sort of their own sourcing or their sort of ethical practice. We try and reduce packaging as much as possible. The packaging that we've got, we try and use biodegradable or things that we can actually recycle down.
The Eden Project set themselves the task of being this painstaking about sustainability. What will make mainstream businesses follow their lead?
We need to look at ways of, you know, making it more affordable to recycle for businesses, making it more accessible, making it easier to understand. On one hand, we want to reduce packaging, but on the other hand, health and safety says you've got to have packaging. So how do you get the balance? And I think that's up to policymakers, in fact.
The Eden Project has more resources and determination to throw at sustainability solutions than most organisations. But there are smaller, equally committed pioneers trying to establish mainstream businesses on ecological principles.